we are seeing that a one color Wahhabi shape or brotherhood shape is coming to rule. It means that the 40% of the Syrian population, which are minorities, are not in comfortable, you know. We don't feel that there will be a stability for us or real rights for us in the future. In the village nearby us, Yabrud, we have a community of 4,000 Christians among 40,000 Muslims. Until today, they were living, until the beginning of the event, they were living with exactly the same rights and duties as the other, because the state was a secular state. Today, the priest of this Catholic community is paying the jizya. He's paying the religious tax to the rebels so that they won't abduct more people of his community to ask ransom. We are living like this today because Yabrud is under the rule of the rebels. In Kara, we are under the rule of the rebel. There is no more police, there is no more mayor, no more any social service. Only the rebels are ruling. Are they ruling with this democracy the world is desiring for us? I would invite any one of you to come and to see. During those 18 years, we have been living in security. Does it mean that we approve the Syrian regime? We don't have anything to say, you see. We were not involved in a political, you know, position. We were just enjoying the life that everybody was enjoying. We were going out maybe after midnight without having any fear. We didn't have a fence to protect our monastery, and we could leave our doors open even the night. Today, under the rule of the rebels, what do we have? We have been obliged to put a wire all around the monastery. We are watching days and night which attack will come, and it is forbidden to any one of us to just put a leg outside the monastery, because we don't know who will come to ransom us, who will come to attack us, who will come to rape us, who will come, you know, to kill us. And even in the local uprising community, you don't have one opposition. You have maybe 50 leaders, each one saying, I am the emir, I am the prince of the uprising. So nobody is responsible of nobody, and banditism is really the fate of everything. So these are the realities we are living, and we fear that slowly by slowly the whole country will fall into this chaos.